Donnie Morehouse was born into a hockey family. He started playing ice hockey at age 8 and helped Cathedral High School win back-to-back Western Mass titles. His late father was an usher at Springfield Indians games when they played at the Eastern States Coliseum. And for 7 seasons, he was the play-by-play voice of UMass hockey. But it's what the 44-year-old father of 4 from Westfield has done recently that is creating quite the buzz in Western Mass hockey circles. It's Tuesday afternoon, and Donnie Morehouse is bringing bags of hockey equipment into the locker rooms at the Mass Mutual Center in Springfield. Everything from sticks to helmets to pads, you name it, more than 90% of which have been donated. Minutes later, a bus pulls up with about 40 kids, grades 3 to 7, from the Savas International Charter School. They exit the bus, grab their bags, and head to their locker rooms. They're there to learn about the game of ice hockey, and at the same time, about the game of life. It was an idea Donnie Morehouse came up with 2 years ago. Introduce hockey to the kids who need it the most, urban at-risk children in the city of Springfield.
What if kids who don't have the opportunity that my kids had, what if they were introduced to hockey? Would the things that get in the way of them getting through everyday life suddenly go away? Kids with, you know, any number of maladies or disorders that prevent them from focusing or being successful in a school setting or in a social setting, all of that. Eventually it was sitting down at the table with my wife, who has heard a lot of ideas from me, and she's gone along with all of them, but this is the first one where she said, that's a good idea. And that conversation led to this.
And this would be the youth program known simply as the Hockey Project.
And people heard about us and they were enthused about it. They liked the idea. And from that, I had a conversation with Bill Foley. He's the head disciplinarian at Sabas, and he knows the type of kids that we're trying to reach.
When Don mentioned to me his brainchild of this hockey project, and it was in its infancy, I shared with him that I had a pool of identifiable prospective candidates for the hockey project at Savas International Charter School.
Good work, everybody.
Thanks to all the grants and donations, the ice time, the transportation, and the equipment for the hockey project are available to the kids at no charge. There's also a group of volunteers who offer their time and talent and experience, which helps Hockey Project teammates like sixth graders Jaleel Gabriel and Kamari Long learn about the game while also learning about themselves.
If I fall on the ice, it teaches me when I fall in life, I can get back up, and all the obstacles around it will help me realize that the ice and the life is the same thing.
When you talk to your coaches, it makes you better when you talk to your teachers. It influences you, it makes you stronger, and it makes you a better person in life.
Jeff Londreville, a student life administrator at Savas and a former hockey player himself, says everyone involved benefits.
When I drive home every single night from the hockey project, I feel like I've made a difference because I see these kids' faces, I feel the confidence, and I see the intensity in their eyes, and finally they believe that I can do it, not only on the ice, but in life, and that's just the biggest reward for me.
Ready?
We've noticed over 2 years an uptick in their interpersonal skills, in their work ethic, and their dedication to their academic pursuits, an uptick in increased grade performance in classroom.
When you put a puck on their stick and tell them to skate around the ice with it, they focus. I wish we could put the puck in the classroom.
On January 1st of this year, some of the players were rewarded with a trip to Fenway Park for the NHL Winter Classic between the Flyers and the Bruins, a trip made possible by the NHL Officials Association.
It was cold, but it was fun. And we got to go backstage and we met the refs, and the refs told us to keep at it. The hockey's a great sport and it's a life skill.
Put the bags in.
On Saturday, March 6th, the kids from the Hockey Project boarded a bus at Savas International School and headed to Connecticut to do something they'd never done before.
Months of practices behind them at the Mass Mutual Center, the players of the Hockey Project wrap up their season on the campus of Wesleyan University in Middletown, Connecticut. Not only was it a tournament, it was the first time ever that these players played in an organized hockey game. Skate your lane, the coach said, defend your goal. And most importantly, when you score a goal, remember to raise your stick. And seventh grader Gilmond Torres had four opportunities to raise his stick during the jamboree, which included teams from Boston, Philadelphia, and Harlem.
It was fun. I felt great. And it was really fun scoring the first goal.
And the hockey project isn't exclusively a male domain either. Just ask seventh grader Jillian Jakes.
I had fun playing, and it's my favorite sport now.
If I tell you one kid is going to come out of our program and change his life and go from a place that's very dark, and very sad, and very lonely to a place where, maybe he's teaching someone else ways to cope, then we did it.